Hi. It is I. It is me. It is what it is. Good morrow to you. Last night I uploaded my second video to YouTube. This will probably be the third. Hello. So, what'd she do? Stop? Oh, there she goes. Anyway, I was thinking, what should this technically a third, but really the second video, blah, 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 bullshit. Last time, I tried to basically introduce who the hell I might be, or at least my perception of it. Today, let me describe where I live and why I live here. I live in Crescent City, California. About 20-ish, 23 miles from the Oregon border on Highway 101. So we have Brookings to the north, Oregon, Brookings, Oregon, and Eureka, California to the south. In between us and Eureka is Last Chance Grade. I've spoken on this. Love that place. Not so much since they put all the pylons in and cut out all the passing zones. Shame that. Anyway. Yeah, Last Chance Grade's something else. Pardon. Anyway, so, Crescent City, California. I was born in Arcata. I'm about 80 miles south of here. College town. Humboldt State University sits there. Was affected pretty much strongly by the hippie movement of the 60s. And then the release of the Vietnam vets they decided that the Redwood Forest was the best place to be. Can't blame them. So why do I live up here? Well, first of all, this is what it looks like most mornings. You know, the fog. Pretty much, yeah, that's most mornings, and it's cool. It's hard to wear glasses or sunglasses or anything else when you ride, but yeah, what the fuck. This joint's gonna fight me. I always win. How I came to be up here. As you know, I spent 38 years in prison. My mother moved up here to take care of my grandmother sometime during that 38 years. I don't know, 25 years or something. I can't. Me and numbers. So she moved up here to take my grandmother, take care of her. And then she came and got me in Arizona and brought me back here. At first, I wanted to move back to Arcata, Eureka. It didn't take long to alter that. Now, there's a lot of bullshit stories and shit, but there was a conversation when somebody asked me to move right after I got out to Yuba City, California, Sacramento area. Basically what I've always referred to as the armpit of California. My father might be buried there, but I'll go there one more time in my life to see if I can find out where he's buried, but neither here nor there. But this person asked me to basically give me an ultimatum. What the hell are you going to do? You going to move or not? I was standing in my driveway. I looked to the right. I looked to the left. Back to the right. And then I looked at the person straight in their eyes. I says, what in whatever fucking universe you create do you think I would leave this for the armpit of California? In my driveway, at that moment, I could see the redwood forest, I could hear the ocean, and the sea lions all at the same time. And I want to move to a dust bowl armpit? I don't think so, folks. So that's why I, or how I came to be in Crescent City. Now, as far as the city itself, this is a beautiful place. It is very picturesque, if you might. We have redwood trees, we have the ocean. This truly is sometimes a place that everyone forgets. But now, in this time, that's a good thing. I take care of my mother and my sister, as I think I've mentioned. I am their care provider. Mom's old and demented, as old people get. My sister is a warrior, but her fight against her body does take a toll. And that brings us to something else that I spoke of. RCs, remote control. Spending 38 years in prison, there are so many things that I never even got to see a picture of, let alone experience with or knowledge, true knowledge of, and hands-on stuff that people sometimes talk about. You must imagine, if you can, and I doubt you can, ...38 years of being deprived. All the things that you take for granted out here. Before 2017, the only electronic game device in our house that existed was Atari Pong. No cell phones, no internet, no computers. And I went from that, stayed in that technology, really, if you think about it, because in prison they did not allow us access to anything while they tried to strip us of our identity and all the other crazy things that probably will be shared or something in time. Anyway, so yeah, here we are, Crescent City. South of us, the Trees of Mystery, Klamath. To the east of us, Jebediah Smith Forest, excuse me. The Boy Scout Trail. This is an amazing place. Especially for someone who spent 38 years on a prison yard where the grass was rocks. And the tree line was a Constantine and chain link fence. Two of them usually, with gun towers and all that other nonsense. So that's Crescent City, California. I do love this place. I truly do. Now, let's move on. I have a couple of minutes today left. Some things are becoming clearer. Other things need work, of course. Always. S&K Mini Motorsports. The title came from my sister's brain. We spent the last year of the pandemic learning, building, a lot of building, and just trying to get enough of a handle so that we could enjoy what RC has to offer. What this channel, as far as that aspect of it goes, I will bring to you. Are just our adventures. I'm not going to review things. I'm not going to promote stuff for a lot of reasons, but the primary reason is this. I don't fucking know how. I've watched guys, Kevin Talbot, RC Sparks, amongst others, and how they do this in way of a business. I'm not a used car salesman. I don't know how to teach or lecture. As I keep trying to tell certain people here recently. My method of teaching when I was on the yard was very simple. I tell you what the fuck you do it or you get smashed. That was pretty much it, really. I'm going to keep this one a little short today, I think. Just because, you know, you're probably fucking bored. In closing for this morning, that was it. S&K Mini Motorsports and KL LaRue YouTube channel is going to be about a brother and sister and a nephew and my transition and our fight to keep me out of prison and a free man. I don't know what I have to offer. It doesn't really matter. If you're paying attention, cool. If you're not, see ya. Those that know me are going to see parts of me and my family that you never quite understood. And hopefully we're going to make somebody laugh because we do some really stupid shit. don't blow shit up. We just do old folk stupid shit. Because here it is. I'll be 60 in a couple months. Not even a couple months. Next month, actually. My sister is 53. My nephew is 32. A grown man. I have no understanding on how to communicate with my nephew as a nephew. Because I never had one. I've never been exposed to that. I have a problem dealing directly with children. Because I see them as little, just little people that they should be smarter than they are, usually are. This is why my sister is important. The psychology of my transition, which started 4 years ago, continues and will continue on. As I start to figure out who the hell I am, hopefully I can show some light on how the hell I survived so long where I did. Or it could just end up being something I laugh at when I watch back and people go like, what the fuck was he thinking? But also, I really am an artist. I will be posting videos of some of my paintings that I did in prison. Most of those paintings right now are laying flat in a box under my bed. But there are a lot of things that I want to put out in the universe while I have the opportunity. For so long, I thought I was going to die forgotten. A life sentence in prison is a death sentence. So let's find out why I am still alive and what the fuck am I supposed to be doing here now. With that said, I leave you with this little thing right here. I'll see you next time.